I'm Monique, the co-owner of the Craft Central. Tour you around our store, and I'm gonna teach you a few things of what you can do and the new hobbies that you can learn here inside. See, we have here si Kuya Heppel and si Kuya Bobby. So sila yung mga friendly staff natin here in the Craft Central. So if you guys need anything, kung may questions kayo or you're looking for something here, sila yung puntahan nyo. They know where to find the things that you need. We started noong 2014 with the workshops, and under Ink Scribbler pa siya that time. So Ink Scribbler is our calligraphy brand for mga workshops, wedding invitations, design. So it's really more of a design studio. And that's where we started yung calligraphy, watercolor, and stuff. And then when we found out that there were people who need more calligraphy items because it's a little bit difficult to find, that's where the Craft Central was born. I was working for an oil and gas company. Even yung time na yon, at night, I would do yung emails, inquiries on mga wedding invites and stuff. I was really handling the operation side and yung business side of the Craft Central. While my sister, si Alexis, she was doing yung arts, the beauty side of it all. In general, as a family, we're very entrepreneurial talaga. At that time, I was also doing my own accessories business. And we like to make sure na parang there are more opportunities out there. And kung ano pang pwedeng gawin namin, we try to get into it. So here right now, I'm gonna show you mga items na nagawa ni Ink Scribbler. So these are one of the items na we made. And these are the gift cards. So some of these are made by our consigner, but like example, this one, this is under Ink Scribbler. These are the foiled gift cards that we have. So we make this from scratch. So paper lang, the design itself, and even yung foiling part, we make it too. We also have other designs under Ink Scribbler for these. And it's almost for any occasion, like yung congrats, happy birthday, first year, kahit yung mga anniversary we have it here. Aside from that, here are yung mga art materials namin. So these are things yung medyo mahirap hanapin, which are the nibs. So we have vintage nibs and yung mga regular nibs natin. So yung vintage, yun yung medyo mahirap talaga hanapin. They're very beautiful kasi, medyo aesthetic yung nibs na yun. While yung mga regular nibs namin, mas common siyang gamitin. We make walnut ink, we make our own calligraphy inks, and we also have yung gum arabic and other items. In the Craft Central, most of our items naman kasi are for mga teens and above. So even kahit yung mas mature natin na kababayan, they can come here and look for a hobby. We also have items for kids and babies as well. So we have a line called Smart Kiddos, where yung mga kids na toddlers, or not even toddlers, we have mga toys for them too. Here, yung one of our calligraphy kits. Itong kit kasi natin is yung parang pinaka entry-level pack natin. So it's at an affordable price of 495 lang siya. But at the same time, you have everything to start already. Nag-decide na kami na we wanted this full-time because mahirap kasing magka-dream to make something big, but you only put half of yourself into it. You can see kasi the opportunity that you can lose or what you're capable of when you put everything, your time into it. So here we have yung paint by numbers. Parang this is under Craft Central, but at the same time, parang Ink Scribbler item ito. This is Palawan. You can paint Palawan. It's within your reach na. You just have to follow yung mga numbers na yan. And it's an original item by the Ink Scribbler Craft Central. We've focused on Philippines. We want things na parang everything Philippines. We have our own washi tapes by Ink Scribbler na Philippines red, postcards, magnets, so pangpasalubong, but at the same time, when you love your country, you will get yung mga items talaga na for your country talaga. With the Craft Central, we have a lot of hobbies that you can find here, and one of the more popular hobbies that we have would be yung ating crochet. Crochet and needleworks. So you can also get yung mga parang starter kits natin so that you can start and make your own beanie and stuff. This is what we have, yung embroidery kits natin. And it's also Philippines yung thing. So you have your banawe. One of our best sellers though, which is the butanding. Super cute. Because the Philippines, parang recently, we really got famous for our whale shark. The name, the Craft Central, we were thinking about it for a while. Marami kaming names na napag-isipan. Parang meron part na nag-isip kami, Craft Haven, kung ano-ano. But the main idea was a place where yung crafts, parang it's like a boiling point of where everything can be. Not only items that we make, kasi yun naman yung nag-start ng Craft Central, yung items namin. But at the same time, we kinda knew na there were other people who need the opportunity to sell their items. If we needed that kind of opportunity, there would be probably other people na crafters rin who needed a place. That's why we thought of this place, Craft Central, where every kind of craft can be. So we have jewelry, and yung jewelry namin are made by the consigners themselves. We found out during the pandemic that technically we are non-essential, but we were able to sell. That time, I would pull out from the stores, I'd bring the items to our home, and I started posting online kung anong items pwedeng people can buy. And it was really, like every day, I would get a lot of orders. And yes, it may not be food, it may not be parang water, utilities and stuff, but it's technically essential kasi it helps with your peace, for you to remain calm. And during the pandemic, I believe that's where we were able to help other people. Na yung nagiging, they were getting bored kasi they were all locked up at home. So if government-wise, hindi talaga kami essential, that's true. But parang as a whole person, it became essential to me and other people. Kasi they were really asking kung pwede today na kunin na nila, ganyan. So it felt na there was really a need for it that time. With anything naman kasi, kaya siya maging profitable as long as there is a need for it. But that's where yung business side comes in. Kasi if you choose to make beautiful things, but at the same time, you sell it for something less than how much you gave to make it, it won't be profitable. And even if dun sa materials pa lang, let's just say that yung materials mo, you cover it. But your time, the effort, if you don't account for that, it won't be profitable at the end. I mean, there will always be passion, especially when you're earning, when it's profitable, but when it becomes parang too tiring just because you feel like it's not worth it anymore, so it won't be profitable. And that's when you realize na profit is not only just money, but profit is also yourself and yung peace that it gives you. So is craft a profitable business to start this season? Well, it's Christmas season. So pag Christmas, almost anything sells. Even yung mga slow-moving items mo, gagalaw yan. We actually have items here that, example, last Christmas, ni namin siya na benta, or may natira pa, we just keep it here. And then by Christmas, we're kind of positive. Or sure that it's gonna start moving because people will start looking for it. If it's for the season, yes. If for the other months of the year, there is always a way for it to be profitable. And it's if you really work hard. It takes a lot of time and effort to make something work. For us to stay in a mall, that's true. Mall rentals are quite expensive. And what's also a challenge is this space is never yours. So if the mall decides to kick you out, you're out. Even if you paid to create this whole store. What we do is we try to make ourselves relevant. And that's through the workshops, and that's through like making new products. So for here in Vertis North, we really make a lot of spaces for other crafters. And we created these spaces so that other people can have that opportunity to sell. And with that, of course, we also charge rent from them. We really take care of our consigners. I heard kasi some people do 6 months agad, you have to pay agad for the rentals. Kami, it's more of you start selling first, then from there, you get yung what you sell, ililessen natin yung mga commissions, then you just keep on going. Versus yung others na sobrang laki ng kailangan nila ilabas para lang maka-join ng isang shop. So it's really also a part of the business to give that opportunity. And I think it's very important that you give that kind of rule. Kasi when I was starting, my mom would always tell me na, yeah, even if you're not paying for the electricity or the gas, you have to account for that. So if you're a kid na parang you get things for free, you start pricing your items really cheap. But pag alam mo na talaga na aside from yung gas utilities, may rent ka pa, you have to like, you know, put that and like you have to start foreseeing kung ilan yung mababenta mo para mabawi mo lang siya. That's where the real business sets in. And even with crafts, hindi kasi talaga siya all art. It's really art and yung ano, yung business management part. Kasi if you just do art lahat, then magiging free na yan eh. Hindi na siya something that will be profitable in a sense na you can just keep on drawing, tapos papamigay mo na lang siya, ganyan. You really have to think of every portion na ginastos mo for it. So, for this area, ito yung parang yung nag-uso yung fandom, pati yung mga stickers. Ito siya. So, we put most of our consigners here na into the fandom, into the stickers. Kasi we really have people who come here to check out the items. And most of the time, mas mabilis talaga masold out dito. Kasi parang pinagsama-sama talaga namin everything that's pretty much the same. And actually, that's one of our rules. Kapag may items that are similar, you put it together so that people can choose from everything. These are yung mga art items that we have. And ito yung mga sets actually that were moving really quickly during the pandemic. Like, every other day, I have to go back to the store just so that I could replenish yung mga koi sets. Here, I want to show you yung mga available spaces namin. Well, technically right now, for Vertis North, we actually have a few spaces left na lang. And we're really happy kasi that's what makes us Craft Central. We're a place where you can find an opportunity to sell your items at home. Kasi kung mas konti yung spaces available, meaning nun, our consigners are staying and they're able to sell. And at the same time, it's easier for us to bawa yung rental being asked from us from the malls. Most of our consigners are based within Metro Manila, but we have around 20% na consigners that are based in Cebu, meron rin kaming taga Palawan and stuff. So yung mga consigners na yun, they get their sales na through deposit. Thank you na may mga ganun na tayong ways to make sure na na-remit nila yung sales nila. But like here, one horizontal box for us is 1,500 pesos minimum rent or commission, whichever is higher siya. And for us, if you want to join the Craft Central, you'd have to show first yung mga products mo because we really make sure that the people or yung mga products that come in are mostly yung Filipino-made or original items because we don't want rin na kinuha lang sa internet and then parang printed out and stuff. We want it pretty original and to make sure that there's a fighting chance for them to sell. Because as much as it's important for us to have mga spaces filled, it's also important for us na we get quality people selling items here. Para balik-balikan. And at the same time, it's less effort. Para masyadong maraming turnovers and stuff. So we really want to screen them well and make sure that they're the quality consigners. If you want to join the Craft Central, first off, you have to prepare yung product portfolio mo para we can check kung these items are things that we can still include in the store. Because we try our best na example, for specific concepts na masyado nang marami sa store, we try to lessen them. Example, for mug concepts, we'll only allow around one or two mug concepts para lang to make sure na hindi siya magsasapaw ng each other ng sales. So we do our best na yung mga concepts are specifically controlled siya. So example, mga reusable straws and stuff, parang since most of those items aren't super unique, we only allow like one or two consigners that hold that kind of product here. For stickers and stuff, most likely you'll get approved naman, basta very original items po siya. So yun. After that, we'll respond whether or not you get in. And from there, we'll show you our rates, we'll show you our contract, and we'll show you the available spaces in our store. After that, you just have to settle yung joining fee and yung security deposit, which is refundable. And from there, send us your barcodes, and then the next day, you can already be part of the Craft Central. We really encourage yung mga SMEs to join us because even if you're small lang, it's really something that you can still do. And very manageable naman yung mga spaces namin. If you have a business that you want to put in malls, you can start sending us an email to join. the aesthetic that we wanted is medyo maarte. Pero I believe naman that you can actually create a store, especially if it's small, that you can spend around 300,000 only, tapos kaya mo na i-build yan. Basta maliit yung store mo. Pero when you're in a mall, actually, with a space as small as 15 square, sa construction deposit and security deposits pa lang, that 300,000 pupunta na yun dun sa mall. So, sometimes, or most of the time, aabot ka talaga ng around a million just to make a store come to life. Example, for rentals. Kung small lang kasi store mo, sometimes yung rental mo is around 50,000, ganyan. So, with sales, nababawi naman namin siya usually on the leaner months. Tapos, what we do is, we really just have to work up and make sure na laging refresh yung mga items natin and stuff. Right now kasi, since we have a number of branches, what we do talaga is, we really compile what items that we have, then after that, we deliver it to the stores. Pero when we started small talaga. And I think that's one of the best things that you have to do. You have to start with what you're comfortable with. So example, I think in the past, around 20,000 pesos, that could buy so many items na, the craft materials. And from there, pwede mo siyang i-flip and mabebenta mo siya at around 30,000. So meron kang 10,000 na kikita. But even with that, even if pag na-flip mo na yung items na yan, you have to use the amount that you sold para bumili ulit ng more. Tapos, it gets a little bit tricky when you start making your own items. Kasi when you create something from scratch, it may look cheap kasi you bought raw materials lang or yung raw material mo is actually you as a person. Ang hirap kasi mag-price ng something na ikaw gumawa mismo. So sometimes, stickers can be made and their cost for like a whole sheet is around what, 200 pesos? Pero with that 200 pesos, that can create around mga 5 sticker packs. With that, parang yung puhunan mo for that is around 40 pesos per pack, but you can sell it at around 200 pesos a set because iba kasi kapag ikaw gumawa from scratch. And that's something that other people may not understand kung nalaman nila na, ay, 40 pesos lang pala yung ginastos mo for that. But actually, yung malaking binabayaran talaga nila is your art. And art is up to you kung paano mo siya ipaprice. It's up to you kung ano yung value mo for yourself and for how it looks like. Usually, if you want something to sell fast, then you price it cheap. But also, at the same time, when you price it too cheap, sometimes people don't see or parang they can think also na parang it's too cheap of an item. Why would they buy it? So it's really about fairly pricing every item that you have to make sure na people get what they deserve. Some people kasi, when they buy something, they also care about the price that it was bought for. It's too cheap. They don't value it as much. So the potential of a person who'd like to start their business in the craft central or their own crafts item, malaking potential talaga siya. It really just matters on your design. It matters on the variety of the items that you have. So you can start small and just sell mga small sticker packs or like keychains. But let's say in 1 or 2 months, you'll have to do something new or else people won't come back for you. Most of our customers here, at least we believe 50% are regulars. So the others are parang passerbys. They check the store and then they buy something that they like. Pero yung mga regulars natin, tumitingin talaga yan. Sina-scout lahat ng mga boxes dito. And they really check what's new. If they see your item, tapos parang yun na talaga siya for the past months, your space, it won't start moving at some point. And that's when we really have to remind our consigners na parang please refresh your items, restock them, or create something new. Kasi yun yung only way for you to get or for you to continue having profitable sales every month. Kahit na super mabenta yung items mo, at some point, all the people rin will know na, ayun yung items niya. We have some consigners na for a year, ito lang talaga item niya for the whole time. Tapos, parang ngayon, starting na mag-slow down yung sales niya kasi wala pang something new. Unless your products are yung parang art essential siya talaga. Example, mga paints and stuff, yun, kahit na hindi ka nag-create ng something new, bebenta siya kasi it's a need na they need to keep on replenishing. For example, mga stickers, mga keychains and stuff, these are more of wants. Kaya yun yung mas important. I believe talaga at some point, kung you don't have or you don't believe in yourself and you don't have the passion to, like, you know, make sure that continuous growth ka, ang hirap siya for you. It's such a huge challenge kasi you have to be inspired, making sure na you have new products. And there's always that kind of doubt na parang, oh, bebenta ba to? Hindi ka sure kung bebenta siya or something. But I think isang malaking thing is, malakas na loob lang. Very, very important na malakas yung loob mo para lang you push it. Sometimes kasi, if your items aren't so nice, you can just start small. Tapos kung di siya gumalaw, then create something new and then push it again until maka-hit ka ng spot na yan, gusto na ng mga tao yan. If you have your own products, it's easy for you to count kung ano yung cost for your product and then how much can you earn from it. So example, sometimes patong ka ng 30% or 50%, up to you kung anong how much papato mo or gawin mo siya on times 2, it's up to you. But when it comes to a big store, it's totally different given that you have fixed cost, which is like the rental, the overhead, but at the same time, you also have products and parang rentals available. So there are times na, example, kung hindi puno yung store mo, the possibility of you to pay for the rental will actually be difficult kasi there are not a lot of people who are selling in your store rin. But at the same time, you also have your own products that help you pay for that rent. It's not an easy solution given that you have your own products that you're selling that will help you pay for your rent the whole time. But at the same time, you have support from consigners who are also renting from you. And when it's in a mall, mas mahirap kasi talaga siyang bawiin. But there are times, like usually pag Christmas season or the season na when you feel that you wanna come to a store and like buy something for others, yun yung time na it's easier for us to actually bawi yung sales. Kasi we've been in the business for around 6 years now. And because of the pandemic, we were hoping that year, dun talaga kami mag-ROI na. Kasi ang mahal kasi to create stores eh. It's not cheap. That's why yung pandemic, we were hoping that year, makakatulong talaga siya to pay for our mga stores that we built. But since the pandemic, parang, oh, we feel like we're back from scratch. Kasi aside from that, there were days, or there were months na we were being asked to still pay rent, and there were months na parang, okay, yung rent mo is kusa na lang, parang small part pa rin, pero gets mo, you're still paying a little bit of rent. So it's not easy to parang bawi talaga everything. But we're hoping talaga in the coming two or three years, ma-ROI na namin yung mga branches namin para at least by then, it's easier for us to expand further again or at least parang ma-balik lang namin yung money that we spent for creating the stores. The reason why na we opened sa mga malls talaga yung mga branches namin is we wanted the space for the consigners and of course for us to have the maximum exposure. Since our Greenbelt Mall was really doing well naman. First, kasi it's the first of our branch. So kung may mga tao na naghahanap talaga sa amin, pupunta talaga sila doon. So because of that, it was easier for us to feel na parang it's a lot safer to open in the other malls. Even if, like, even for Greenbelt, it was difficult rin for us to start. And very overwhelming siya. Kasi hindi ka pa sanay to pay for yung mga construction and stuff. Pero because you had to do it, you had the dream for it, you'd push for it. So that's when you realize na parang a lot of it is about being guided by the Lord. And a lot of it is, you know, parang praying so hard na it works. And aside from, of course, aside from 100% effort, there's 100% guidance na parang Lord, basbasan mo kami, ganun. Kasi some people call it swerte, but for us, we believe lahat yan God-given. So kung gusto mo talaga mag-move yung items mo and stuff, kung i-guide ka ni Lord, bibigay niya yan sa'yo. So yun, that's a big factor for us too. Okay, so today I'm gonna teach you how to make yung walnut ink. And these items are all available here in the Craft Central. So first is you need your walnut crystals. They're called walnut crystals kasi it's really made out of walnut husks. 2 jars of our walnut ink. We just need 1 teaspoon ng walnut crystal. And then, kailangan lang natin after that is 1/2 distilled cup of water. Very easy kasi to do yung walnut ink natin and it's ready made talaga. And then, from there, okay na siya. Yung dating ng walnut ink, it's medyo sepia. So when people ask us, na parang ba't di siya black or something, it's really made to be colored brown. Ito yung laman ng scribble kit natin. So we have yung nibs na, we have yung holder, alphabet scribble pad, which is yung first 26 leaves natin, may alphabet siya that you can copy. Then afterwards, it turns blank. So you can start creating your own. And then aside from that, may scribble manual siya. And this manual was made by Ink Scribbler talaga. And then from scratch. So it teaches you talaga how to do calligraphy. Usually, after you create yung ink mo, of course, you want to test it before you start bottling it or before you start selling the ink. So anything that we have on hand, we test it first para we make sure na success. Sometimes, kung ikaw specifically, if you want to make something this size, it's important to have a very good partner. So for me, my partner is my sister, si Alexis. And she's really brilliant. Another thing that helped us grow is also because of how we manage things. So kami, we separated our roles well, and parang we have a joke na parang, okay, kanya-kanyang problema, ganyan. Kasi if you keep on like sharing masyado like your problems, and of course, with this kind of store, there are many things talaga na issues, not only the example, we have restocking, we also have yung parang pwede rin sa staff, pwede rin siya sa consignors. There are many factors, and aside from that, you have to create something new things para the store keeps on staying refreshed and alive. So yun nga, you have to focus on your own problems, and then pag you feel like you foresee na this is something I cannot do, that's when you call for help. So that's one of the things that we learned na for as long as kakayanin mong i-fix yung problem, fix it first. But habang ongoing yung problem, tapos alam mo, kaya mo naman siya, we just inform yung shallow portion and say, nakaya ko na to. Tapos go lang. There was a time na we opened our branches na sabay-sabay and we had to borrow money. We kind of knew na parang not all of the stores were also doing well, kasi sometimes habang when you're building a new store, yung other branch, mapapabaya mo siya. So even if we knew that there were days na parang, okay, hindi siya nagbe-break even, what my sister told me is, wag mong pansinin yan. Let's just focus and keep on fighting. Tapos at the end of the year, nabawi namin yung losses and stuff. So, ang laki ng factor ng believing in yourself and like keeping your eyes in your own lane, hindi mo na pinapansin yung mga other factors dyan na that will keep you or like will bring you down. Ang laking factor nun na parang ano. And it takes a lot of strength or like yung grit na parang, yes, kaya ko to, and yun. Being able to learn to detach yourself from emotions, yung emotional things. Kasi if, example, may mga problems ka with a customer or a consignor, tapos nauna mo yung emotion mo, hindi ka makakaisip rationally. And mapapahiya ka lang talaga. Example, nagagalit na siya. Tapos, of course, kung nagagalit siya, sometimes, yung reaction mo is magalit ka rin. So, it's really important na to pause and smile and like, don't attach yourself. Isipin mo kung ano yung situation before you add your emotions. Kasi, ang laking toll ng emotion rin on how you are as a person, bringing it home to your family, that's super big. One of the things I always tell my staff, lalo na kapag nag-aaway sila or something, I tell them na parang, guys, your work here in the Craft Central, this should be like 20% of your life lang. Remember na, mas important is happiness nyo. And I know that money is very important kasi that will feed your family and stuff. Pero if it doesn't make you happy, hindi siya worth it. I always tell them that. Kaya, example, pag may konting mga bickering sa store, I tell them na kung hindi niya siya maayos, isipin mo na if masaya ka pa ba na everyday yan yung mangyayari sa'yo. Kasi, yan, specific people in the stores, pag hindi sila okay together, wala naman ako magagawa, hindi ko naman ako pwede pumili. Ah, ikaw, wala na. Diba? Can't do that. So, I always tell them na you have to learn na parang huwag niyong i-attach sarili niyo masyado rin. Kasi kung masyadong emotional, everyday magdadala ka ng bad vibes, ganyan. So yeah, when you go home, remember mo that your work, that's not you. Your work is something you can leave. Your work is just there to give you sustenance, money, ganyan. Pero at the same time, yung nagsusustain talaga, or the thing that keeps you alive, is your faith, your family, love, friendship, ganun eh, yung mga things na hindi mo mabayaran. Kasi pag family business, meaning nun, kahit sino pwede may pasok, diba? Pero like for us, we really treated it as a business. So like kami dalawa, we really paid for our shares. We really put money into it. We decide things through like discussions talaga. We really do our best to treat it as business. Kasi kung you start treating it like a family business, doon nagkaka-blurred lines eh. Ayaw mo nang ganun. Maguguluhan ka. That's why businesses are easier to maintain kapag wala siyang mga yung family issues na parang, sige, pasok mo ganyan. Cannot eh. Dapat parang, even if we have friends na consigning or like yung family consigning, they still have to pay for rent. Hindi pwede yan libre. Kapag biglang nililibre mo yan, it gets blurred along the way. In the future, when, let's say, kasi linibre mo, tapos kailangan mo ng additional, you feel na parang, you can make that space more profitable by adding someone else, ganyan, kasi you don't earn from it or anything. Tapos, of course, you need additional funds para lang maintain yung rental and stuff. It becomes confusing for the family member kung hindi mo sinet in stone yung mga things that you want to make sure na we have to follow na rules. So yun, one of the things are this. Yung mga rules na yan, follow mo yan. Huwag mo na siyang, parang, hindi, pamilya kita, kaya pa okay lang. Wag. Hirap nun. So yung ating slime party slime kit. So Elmer's glue, and then kailangan natin yung bonding powder, yung activator, ito accessories na lang to. Parang, I wish na we knew na hindi kailangan lahat maganda agad. When we started talaga, we wanted everything beautiful. Maganda yung all of our displays and everything. But at the same time, parang, because of that, it cost more money. And it was also more, mas matagal before mo ma-ROI lahat. And of course, for us, parang, as much as we're really patient, kung mas mabilis mo siya ma-ROI, mas hindi siya as stressful for you. It's also very important, friend, to keep your people happy. It's not easy talaga to make sure na things are okay, kasi sometimes in a store, kahit na you treat your people well, there could be customers, friend, who won't treat your people well. And of course, as much as you want to protect your people, there's a rule nga saying that customers are always right. But at the same time, sometimes you know that the customer can also be unreasonable. So it's difficult kasi you don't want na your people will feel that parang hindi sila pinaglalaban or something. You always want to be on the side of which is right. It's always a balancing act between the two na parang you have to make sure na at the end of the day na you still respect your customers, talk to them nicely. Usually they will get what they want. Usually. But of course, if it's too much, you have to stand your ground. Tapos afterwards, talk to your staff and just explain talaga to them that parang you really try your best to do things. But what we're very thankful for and we feel very blessed na yung mga tao namin are very understanding of the circumstance. Or parang they would tell us actually na sometimes sa past work nila, may mas worst pa sila na experience, and sometimes talaga those things happen talaga. Do I consider the Craft Central a successful store? Yes! We really feel kasi that we were able to reach our dream. And the dream is to be able to allow people to know more about this world of crafts, and at the same time be an avenue for others na crafters who need space na to sell their items. So yes, it is a success story kasi the dream is alive and we want to continue living this dream talaga. So we're still planning kasi talaga to sustain and maintain yung four branches namin. And we want to make sure that yung spaces namin are well filled with the consigners. And for consigners namin, kasi not all of our consigners are in all branches, and we want to make sure na if they have the right stuff or the right products, they should really expand to all of our branches, given that every branch is strategically placed in different city para lang ma-maximize natin kung anong pwedeng, or the people per location. So we plan to continue making sure na our products are refreshed, and also make sure that our consigners are doing well in our store. So for now, yun muna siya. But in a couple of years, we're planning also to open again and expand further. And if God will permit, we will try to have more areas or spaces na workshop available for people. If you guys want to consign with us, please message us lang in through our email, management@thecraftcentral.com. And if you guys are not in Metro Manila and you guys want to order anything from the Craft Central, we can ship it to you. You can check us out or in our Instagram at the Craft Central or through our website www.thecraftcentral.com. So our stores here in Metro Manila, they're open from 11 to currently right now 9 p.m. and we're open daily. So kung may kailangan kayo, just message us. Online naman, we do our best to reply every day. Except on weekends and of course on holidays as well, but we do our best, especially sa Instagram, and we are also available in Shopee and Lazada. And actually, kung you guys are at home, you can check out GrabMart, MetroMart, we're also there, and even in Picaroon. And if you guys happen to drop by any of the malls that we're in, so we're in Mall of Asia, Greenbelt 5, Mega Mall, SM Mega Mall, and here in Ayala Verde Store. So come drop by our store, say hello to our friendly staff, and check out the whole place and all of the items that we have. Thank you!